जय श्री कृष्णा, जय श्री रामचंद्र, जय श्री लक्ष्मीन्द्र सिंह. इट्स वेरी सैड एंड डिस्टर्बिंग टू सी द स्टेट ऑफ आवर कंट्री एंड अदर पार्ट्स ऑफ द वर्ल्ड ओवर द लास्ट टू मंथ्स. इट हैज बीन वेरी स्ट्रेसफुल एंड ट्रेमेंडसली पेनफुल फॉर द एंटायर नेशन एज वेल एज अदर पार्ट्स ऑफ द वर्ल्ड टू. आई बिलीव द ओवरऑल सिचुएशन कुड हैव बीन मच मच बेटर इफ आवर गवर्नमेंट्स, आवर साइंटिफिक कम्युनिटी एंड द जनरल पॉपुलेशन वुड हैव यूज्ड द ट्रेडिशनल नॉलेज सिस्टम्स handed over by our ancient sages like Vedic astrology and Ayurveda for their own benefit in this crisis situation. Vedic astrology and Ayurveda offer immense benefits when it comes to analyzing the future of the whole world, which can be termed as astro-epidemiology, and to treat the disease, to protect oneself from the disease, as well as to find out methods of prevention for the disease if research is done properly in this area. But the negligence of our scientific community as well as the governments, not the entire scientific community but a large part of it, has resulted in immense suffering to the public and loss of countless lives and much more. I believe that the start of the present wave in India has been due to the sixth body conjunction in mid-February, February 10 to 11, and I've talked about this in my video that is dated April 1, 2020, as well as in another video that I've made in January of this year. The worst time of this pandemic for the entire world, if we take the world as a total, has been January and February, when the world saw the highest number of deaths due to COVID-19. For India, it's been the time period between February to April, but not many people knew about this happening in February. Everyone thought that the vaccines are going to make big difference and everything is going to get better. But instead, we saw that February to April, especially April and May, were one of the worst months and many, many people lost their lives. It is time we pay attention to the powers of Vedic astrology and Ayurveda in dealing with any future situation. Just imagine how great it would have been for the entire world at large if we knew what is going to happen and that worse days are coming from this period to this period of time. Let's talk about prevention and cure. The mainstream system versus the Ayurvedic system. When it comes to prevention, the first thing that the funded part of our scientific community as well as the governments talk about is immunization and vaccination. I believe that vaccination is not the solution to our problems, and I've been repeating this since last year. For example, let's look at the effectiveness of vaccines. Let's look at Seychelles, for example. Seychelles, a small nation, the most vaccinated country in the world, is experiencing its highest level of outbreaks in its COVID-19 history. Let's look at Chile, another country that's vaccinated over 60% of its population. It's facing one of the worst times in its COVID history. And when it comes to UK and Israel, UK is yet to begin, and I bet it's going to begin with a bad wave starting June 20th, and it's going to get worse after June 20th. So please don't talk about the success of China when it comes to immunizations, because no data, no relevant data from China can get leaked outside. They're very, very strong when it comes to data protection, and did not reveal everything to the outside world. So we cannot be 100% sure about what's happening in China, and I don't believe it's absolutely fine too there. And at the same time, UK and Israel, please don't keep them as emblems of success. I believe something serious is going to begin even there after June 20th. So I don't really trust in immunizations or vaccines. And second of all, we don't know what's there as ingredients of the vaccines. And third of all, many of them have started to fail, not exactly fail, but many of them have started to tremble in front of the new variants that have been produced during during these tough times. So according to Ayurveda, how do you prevent a disease? That's one of the most frequently asked questions I've ever got. How do you prevent any disease for that matter? If I talk about COVID-19 and its prevention through Ayurveda, this video might be taken down. So let me just talk about any disease. When you try to prevent any disease, the first thing that comes to the mind of a person who has been trained in Ayurveda is sattva of the body. Sattva means the innate strength of the body. That's the immunity of the body, the natural immunity that everyone has. Some people have lesser immunity, some people have more natural immunity. Instead of just terming this loosely as immunity, let's talk about it as natural strength. Overall physical, emotional, mental and spiritual strength of the body. All these together contribute to the power of the body, which can help in fighting any disease, be it tuberculosis or even COVID-19. And modern medical experts will have to agree that the body's innate strength matters the most when it comes to the outcome of the disease. You can be infected, you can get the disease, you can contract the infection, but whether you come out of it easily and how you respond to it, all these things matter, and that is what brings about the final outcome. And Ayurveda stresses on living a healthy lifestyle. Not just taking a few Ayurvedic pills, so-called Ayurvedic pills. When talking about fighting a disease together, we all need to maintain a healthy lifestyle. We all need to expose ourselves to fresh natural air and fresh natural sunlight early in the mornings. That's when our body and mind can get invigorated. Currently, we're being dumped in the worst times, and we've been forced to suffocate ourselves, to not be able to breathe properly and to suffer and be condemned to eternal suffering continuously. Not many people have access to fresh air and natural sunlight. Often they are isolating themselves, you know, they're actually self-isolating themselves. They're not taking good care of their health and they are locking themselves up in small spaces. And I believe that disease spreading rate will be higher in closed small spaces. Not only COVID-19, but every single disease gets worse when people are stuck in one enclosed, covered up space which has no access to fresh air and sunlight. And I can debate on this if required. Along with this, when it comes to the cure part, modern medicine has suffered so badly that the cure has been a cruel joke on the people, I would say. So moment a patient comes, whether they need it or not, they are pumped with steroids, high amounts of steroids in most cases, and their oxygen level starts dropping, the immunity starts dropping, and they become susceptible to dangerous and deadly diseases such as the present epidemic of black fungus, mucormycosis, and even other diseases that might attack them in the future. So I believe that we need to start looking at Ayurveda. Ayurveda helps us look at things in a different way. I don't mean just gobbling a few pills up. I mean maintaining a healthy lifestyle, which I've been stressing on. So I believe we have to change our vision, what we think of diseases. Diseases are not just diseases, but our response of the body, that's what matters the most. And that holds the key to whether we come out of this pandemic with flying colors or whether we continue in this mire. With the present situation and the way things are being dealt with, I believe that this situation is going to continue for a long, long period of time until we all people come together and do something about it quickly. If we utilize our ancient traditional knowledge systems, I believe we can come out of this at the earliest possible time. If we do it all together, we'll be able to prevent even the next wave. Astrologically, I believe that after June 20th, the world is going to see a lot of turbulent times and we need to prepare for that. And when it comes to recovery from this, the way we are going with the disease, the way we are taking the disease, the way the governments are treating it and our scientific community is treating it, I don't believe it's going to get better soon. It's going to take a lot of time. Comparing it with the SARS outbreak of 2001 and 2002, which ended May 2024, I believe that this also is going to take a lot of time. Considering its intensity, that is far, far more than the previous SARS outbreak, it's going to take lots of time to get better, though the economies will start getting better after May 2022. I've stressed on this point even in my previous videos. But if we all make a coordinated effort, a global effort, I don't mean we need to keep waiting for the governments and the scientific communities to tell us what to do. We need to start helping ourselves with a healthy lifestyle and taking care of our health, taking care of our elders and everyone else. That's when things can get better. Last but not least, I believe that faith in God is the key to getting better globally. And it doesn't matter which faith you are from. You can also have faith in God, whether you're from Islam or Christianity or Hinduism. All is that we need to start believing and having faith in the Supreme, who is well above us, and that is holding one of the main important keys to get rid of the problems we have. Thank you. Jai Shri Krishna, Jai Shri Ramachandra, Jai Shri Lakshmi Narasimha.